Hey guys, it's Ileane from basicblogtips.com. We're going to talk about a plugin today, and this one is a plugin for WordPress that's called Digg Digg. Let me just show you. And this was a hugely popular post from my friend Ryan Hanley at ryanhanley.com, and it was called Share Button versus Like Button for Best Facebook Exposure. I gotta admit, I'm showing off a little bit here because this is the Digg Digg share bar, and I just so happen to have, I'd say a few hundred shares and likes on this particular post. So I wanted to show you how to install this plugin and how to have that sharing bar float. And the reason why I like to have it float is because I get a lot of comments on my blog. For example, in this particular post, I have 130 comments. So if someone wants to add a new comment, when they're all the way down here at the bottom of this post, they will still be able to share it, tweet it, or give it a plus one on Google. I wanted to do this tutorial for quite some time, but today it got, my memory was jogged because someone asked me to take a look at their blog. And actually, I think this is a very nice looking blog. Only one problem. This toolbar, the sharing toolbar for Digg Digg, is way over too far on top of their content and their featured post. So I said, hey, your website looks great, but your Digg Digg share bar needs to be moved over. Just go to your settings page. And ta-da, he did it. So now I'm going to show you how to do that as well. Okay, let's swing over. Now we're on the back end of my blog. And before I go any further, I have to give a shout out to our friends who actually took ownership of this plugin. And that's Leo and Joel. They are the owners of Buffer, and they purchased Digg Digg earlier this year. And since they've been behind the helm, they've made a lot of changes that are really, really positive. So once you install the plugin, you'll find it over on your menu on the side. And you're going to see a different modules. And the first one is the global configuration. And it's pretty simple. The number one thing you have to do on this page is to add your Twitter name and add your Buffer name. Okay, if you have these other services like Flatter, or if you're going to use TweetMeme, which we're not going to, or Topsy, then you want to go ahead and put your username in there as well. Now, normal display, let me explain the difference. Normal display just means that your sharing buttons will be spread out horizontally across the page as opposed to the vertical floating bar, which I showed you I'm using. So we're going to skip the normal display because you don't need to have both normal and floating set up. You only need to decide which one you're going to use, and then you'll do the settings accordingly. Okay? So we're going to use the floating display, so let's go into that. Okay, the very first thing, don't skip this box because it's very important. It's the status. You're going to let the plugin know that yes, you are using the floating display. You must check this box. Then you can decide here whether you want it to be on posts, pages, categories, so forth. Personally, I just like for it to be on posts. But if you want it to show up on your homepage, just like the example I showed you is showing up on his homepage. Personally, I didn't want them on my homepage, so I left that off. I only want it to show up on posts. I really don't want people to share my homepage. I'd rather for them to share specific posts. You can always test things. If you say to yourself, no, I want them to share my homepage, then go ahead, check it off. You know, it's up to you. So this is the part that I explained to my friend that he needed to change. How far from the left is the Digg Digg placed. Well, if we go back over to my blog, you'll see here's the left and this is 39 pixels from the left. The next setting has to do with how far from the top do you want the floating bar to start floating. Now let's take this back up to the top of the page. And it looks like the top of the post starts probably right around underneath where it says this is a guest post. And then it starts to float. And as you can see, it floats all the way down, as I mentioned earlier. We want to make sure that when people are leaving comments that they have those sharing tools handy. So that's the next setting. Let the Digg Digg bar float past the end of the post. And yes, we want that. Now, here's where you're going to choose which sharing options you want to appear on that bar. And all the weight means is the one with the highest number is going to be on top. So therefore, I have Google Plus there. And if you look at the bar, the first thing there is the Google Plus one. And then I have Facebook like next. See, I have it checked. It also has to be checked off. And then I had Twitter, and then I have Blog Engage. Okay, you have a whole host of other options here. I've actually tested some of those. You can have the Digg sharing bar there. You can have Buffer. And right now I'm testing it with Buffer being off, but I've toggled back and forth. Sometimes if you give people too many options, they don't do anything. So these are the core ones I want them to do. I'd rather them go ahead and tweet it now. And it's been effective in some cases. I know other people like to buffer, but my feeling is this. I'm a Buffer user. I love Buffer. So what I do is I have the Buffer extension installed up in my toolbar. So when I'm on people's blogs, I probably would rarely ever use the Buffer sharing over in the Digg Digg toolbar. That's just me. So like I said, you have to test, you have to know your audience and know which one will get the most use. And you'll know because you'll see the numbers, you'll see the counts. For example, here's another more recent post. This was actually just published yesterday. And still, I have a fair number of tweets and likes. So, you know, like I said, you will test to see what works for your audience. Any of these other buttons, if you don't have, because of your theme, it doesn't display the number of comments you have, maybe this is the opportunity where you want to display that as well. Now, I don't do the lazy loading, and I'm not going to cover that in this video. You could go ahead and test it. The main things that I wanted to go over with you is your options for whether it's going to appear on a post or pages, and also whether you're going to float, how far you're going to float it, if you're going to use the normal display, or the floating display. Now, if you have feedback, these guys, Joel and Leo, they're very responsive. You see that they even have a feedback button there. So go ahead. I urge any blogger, even if you're not personally active on social media, people who come to your blog, especially when it comes to Facebook, if they have that option there, where they can just click that and give that post a like. This is also going to share it for you. You can post that right on Facebook. I'll do it now just to show you how quickly it works. And you always want to have those sharing options available for any visitors that come to your blog or your website. So that's it for today. And hey, do me a favor while you're over on my YouTube channel. Hit that subscribe button right up on the top. Right now we are so close to 800 subscribers. We have 778 subscribers, and we're almost at 70,000 views. Thanks to everyone who has been supporting and watching the videos and giving the thumbs up. Okay, I'll talk to you guys soon. Once again, it's Ileane from BasicBlogTips.com. Talk to you soon. Peace.